mostly students find it very difficult to understand this topic, and as I told you, this is very important topic by exam point. So you should understand the basic concepts of mole concept clearly so that you can solve the questions based on this. First of all, the first question is, what is mole? Mole is the unit of quantity of matter. Mole is nothing, but it is used to indicate a number. Just like we use dozen, a unit. In the same way, mole is a unit used in mainly chemistry to indicate a certain amount of number. Because in chemistry we deal with very small particles like atom, electron, molecule. These all are very small, so small that we cannot measure anything about them. We cannot measure their mass, we cannot measure their dimensions. So we need a number in order to measure and calculate their physical properties, and that number is mole. One mole atom, one mole molecule, one mole ions, anything. One mole contains this number of particles, that is 6.023 × 10⁻²³ particles. One mole atom will, that means if we are talking about one mole of sodium atom, that means we are talking about 6.023 × 10³ part atoms of sodium. One mole, that means this much number. If we talk about one mole carbon atoms, that means we are talking about 6.023 × 10³ carbon atoms. This is the number associated with the term mole. Mole means this much particles. So mole is nothing but this number. This number, which is also known as Avogadro number. We will use, in fact, this number is used in almost every numerical problem of chemistry in which we need to calculate something, mainly in physical and inorganic chemistry. We use this number in almost every mathematical calculation. Sometimes we write it in just this form, 6.023 × 10³, and sometimes we write it in a short form, that is NA. NA is Avogadro number, which is nothing but this. In our next point, let's discuss about masses, atomic mass and molar mass. Atomic mass means mass of one atom. Yes, atomic mass means mass of one atom. But if you have ever noticed, atomic mass is represented by two units. Sometimes we use a unit AMU, that is atomic mass unit, or in simple form U, only U, that is unified unit for atomic mass. And sometimes we denote the atomic mass by gram. But why do we do so? Sometimes we write just mass of atomic mass of oxygen is 16 U or AMU, and sometimes we write it atomic mass of oxygen is 16 gram. These are two different units, U, that is AMU, and G, that is gram. These two different units